Today's topic is object relationship between two different objects. Object relationship. What is a relationship? Association between two different objects or two different tables is called here relationship. There is a association in the database management system. Foreign key, primary key association is there. For example, one table primary key pointing the other table field. That is called here foreign key concept. Here also that concept existed in a Salesforce. Here object relationship in Salesforce. Object relationship nothing but a two-way association. It is a association between two different objects. One object, another object. Here that is sometimes that is called here parent-child relationship. But here not having any inherent concept here. Here one object record information is linked to one object record information linked to another object record information. Object record information linked to another object record information. Here that is called here a relationship. Here this particular relationship represented one parent record is associated to many child record here. Here one parent record is there, one parent table. For example, department is a one table. That is, let us assume that is a parent table that is linked with many employee table, associated with many child records. The parent object can have many child object, but the child object must have only one parent. That is called here this particular information. You have a two types of relationship existed here. Sometimes it may be a one-to-one relationship or many-to-many relationship. You may define the many-to-many. Here the master detailed relationship, master table or detailed table. The master table you call it as a parent table, or child table you call it as a detailed table. Let us assume. And then lookup relation. Here this is a some information. This master detail relation, lookup relation is a one to many relation. One to many, that means one master table, many child table. One parent table have the many child table, or many parent have the, like that you have a master child relationship. Here comes to the standard objects cannot detail table. Here the standard object may be, for example, account is a standard object. Here the standard object, it may be a master table, but here it's not a detailed table. That means it's not a child table. For example, account cannot be detailed table. Here the master detail relationship field is required on a page layout of a detailed object. Here the navigation for this one, let us take a simple example. Same, the college information system. Here you have a department number. In the employee table you have a department number. Here department having the department number. Here in the database management system, department number is a primary key of a department table. Here in this case, ordinary key, the primary key pointing to the other table field. The primary key pointing to the other table, but here not depends upon a fields here. Here it depends upon a records. See this one, that's a depends upon a record value. Here what is that one? The parent object and the many child object. Here one parent record here associated to many child records. Here this case is different, one parent record, many child records, like that. That means you have to take the record here. Here how can you take the, that means you have to follow the two concepts. Here is a, one is a EMP table, other one is a DEPT table. In this case DEPT table is a master table, EMP table is a child table. DEPT is a master table. Here for the master table you have to creating the information. DEPT is a child table. That means you have to create these two table and then provide a relationship between these two tables. For example, let us take a simple DEPT table. First, I am inserting the data into DEPT table. Department number 10. The department number 10 equal to CSC department, location equal to Hyderabad. And then, for example, department number 20. The department number 20 equal to ECE department. The location equal to HOD Hyderabad. For example, department number 30. Let us, it is a primary key. A Tribble department, let us assume. And then location here is Hyderabad. Here in this way we have a department number 40 also there. Here that means IT department here. IT department, the location also same Hyderabad. Here comes to here. It is a tailed table. Here in this case, department is a master table. Master relation. Department is a master relation. Here comes to the child here. The child here is a here for the master. You are employee number. Here, what is employee number? Let us assume one is employee number. Department name equal to Samuma, the employee name, and then salary equal to 9000. And then department number equal to, let us assume D10. He belongs to CSE department. Uma is an employee, belongs to CSE department. Here second role. For example, Rama. Rama having the, for example, 6000 salary. He belongs to department number 20. No problem. For example, Samtri is there. Samtri belongs to bioinformatic department. For example, bioinformatic department not existed in our college. Here, for example, Suresh. Suresh is a one person. His salary equal to 9000. Here, when I am going to creating this 20 or 60, department number 60, it gives a error. Here, why? Because the parent, the department number linked with the parent. Here the department number is there. The department number linked with the parent field. That's why it is not having the authority. Okay, let us take a simple. Here, this one, this department number. Here, this department number. Let us take here. Here the department number linked with the department here. There is a link is there from here. If you want to add 60, it's not possible to add 60. This is called here master child. That means there is a relation, master child relation. Here you will implement that master child relation by using Salesforce. Here comes to the Salesforce department home. Here, that means the there is a, some conditions are there. If you want to create the master child relation, you have the some conditions. What are the conditions here? I am telling you the condition here. The master table relation. The master table. The if you want to create a master table, that should be simple information. What are the simple information here? That you don't have any field for the master table, and then not having any child field for the table. Let us assume, okay, leave it. I want to already, I am having the department table. I am going to deleting the table, and then comes here. Here, how can you delete the table here? Same setup. Here, coming to the create. I want to delete the table object. Go to object. And then delete option here is there. I am deleting for anything. I am going to deleting the table. Here, this one. I am deleting this one. Yeah, I deleted the DVT table. What is the thing here? First, I need to creating the master table. After that, I need to create the child table. Master table is a DEBT. First, I should create the DEBT table. How can I create that DEBT table here? Go to setup. That means I'm going to creating the object. Go to setup. Here setup, you are having the object. In the object, new object. Here object name. What is an object name here? DEBT is an object. Here the object here also DEBT. Create that one. No problem here. Department number, from the department number I am taking, no problem. DEBT number. First, it will display the first value. That's why DEBT number, and then save it. Next, Next thing, I created the department number. Here I need to add the department number tab. Let us assume, the department number to the, I'm going to add tab. Tab the department number here. I want to see department number here. How can you see the department number? I'm going to create in the new tab. The tab name here is a department. The tab object here, and then style. You may select the any one of the style, and then create next. Next, click on all and then save it. Yeah. You created a department table, but I did not add any field. Here, what is the problem here? If you want to provide a master relation, master table not have not contain not master table, child table not having the records, not having the records. That means in order to getting that inconvenience, that means in order to remove that inconvenience, I am starting from table. Next, I am going to creating the another table. What is another table here? Employee table. Next, I'm going to creating the employee table. What is an employee table? This is an employee table. Yeah, this employee table, create an employee table object. Yeah, new object. The object name here is a EMP. Here employee. The plural also EMP, no problem. Here it will take the value. Here save it. Okay, takes some time. Yeah, it will create that one EMP table. It will create an EMP table. Add this EMP table to the tab. How can you add? Go to setup again. Here, create in the under create here, tab it. Tab new. EMP and then anyone come here, click here, click on save it. Here you added the EMP table as well as the department. Here I need to fill the fields. How can I fill the fields? What are the fields for the department table? Department number, department name, department salary. Here I'm going to creating the, that means if you want to create the master child relationship, here you are taking the EMP table. Here what are the values for the EMP table? EMP number is there, that means verify that one. I want to verify and then I want to modify that fields value. Here comes to the EMP, create object. Here, open the edit the EMP object. If you edit the EMP object, your name is there. No problem. EMP number. EMP number. Why? Because I need to add first. That's why I'm typing the EMP number. Yeah. First thing I want to add field for the department. What are the field for the department? What are the field here having the department and the what are the field? These are all fields for the department. Here, department number, department one. These are all fields. Department number, I'm going to add the department field first. Here, adding the department one. Yeah, I'm going to adding the department name. I can add the field here. Click on here. First, you have to add the field. Here, how can you add the field here? Go to setup. Go to setup. Under the setup here, you have a create option. Under the create, you have a create option. Go to object. Here, you will add the field. Here, for example, for the department, first, I am selecting the field. Here, what are the field for the department here? Why? Because it is a master table. First, I added the all field for the master table. After that, I am going to add in the child table fields. Yeah. First, I am going to add in the field, new record, new field here. The already EMP number over e name. E name here is a text field. E name, not department number over department name. I click here, DEPT name, DEPT RD name, department name. Here department length here is a 180, otherwise 30. Okay, if you required 30, take the 30 and then select next. No problem, next. And then save on new D name over and then department location. The next department location also a text field. Click on text next. Department location here length 30. I am taking length 30. Comes to here. That means everything okay, fine. Go to next. Save it. You added the all fields for the table. Open the department here. Here only it displays the one field here. Go to here. It displays the only one field here. How can you see the all fields here? That means you have to select that field to display. Select that field. Select field to display. First department number. Next department name and then next department location and then save it. Yeah, if you comes to the department, click on here. Yeah, department number, department name, location is there. Next, I want to add the employee table. Here, what are the fields of employee? Here you have a fields of employee. Here is a employee number, employee name, employee salary, and then department. Four fields are there. I need to add the four fields for the department. Here first I want to add the four fields. How can you add the four fields? Here go to here, click on objects, here EMP field. EMP field, in the EMP field comes to here, custom fields and relationship. Click on new. Here already EMP number is there, e-name. I need to add the e-name. The e-name here is a text field. Click on new. Employee name. The field name is a e-name. Employee name. The value here 30. And then click on new. No problem. Next. And then save new. Employee number, employee name, next field. What is the next field here? Employee number, employee name, employee salary. The other field here is a employee number, employee name, salary. Salary is a number type. Click on next. The salary, employee salary here, salary. Here, employee salary 18, and then next click on. Click on next. Save it. Here, when you want to add the next field here, very important case here, Kim. Here, I already department table created and then field added. Here, department number. Here, what is the department number here? It maintains a master detail relationship. Here, the department number of employee or department number of DEPT having the master child relationship. Here, DEPT is a master table. The and child table here is a EMP. Here, you have to maintain this type of information. Next, when you want to create the this information, then you will apply the master table relation. Here, if you comes to the here, go. This one here, department number, department names, department salary. If it comes to here, go. Okay, it's not added here. That means you may add here, edit that one. You may add these fields, employee number, employee name, employee salary, salary. Edit that one. The next field here is, what is the next field? Department number of an employee. How can you create the department number of an employee here? If you want to create it, this is called here child table. If you want to select the child table department number, then click on here. Here I want to add that field here. How can I add that field? Go to setup, same, create object. Here the object here is a employee. Itni employee I am going to be creating the department table. Here comes to the custom field relation. Here click on new. Click on new. This new here is a employee relation. Here it is a master detail relation. Here master table is a department table. I am going to selecting the detail table relation. Click on next. Click on next. Here related to which table, which master table, who is the master in this case? Select the object to which this object relate to. That means who is the master? Department is the master. Here in this case, so many tables are there. All standard tables works as a master table. Here department is a master table. Child table is employee table. The child table, the master table department number pointing to the child table department number. Here that is a relation. Next. Here name here. That means field label. Any, for example, DEPT number or same number. You may use another number also. For example, for simplicity, DEPT number 1. The field name here is a DEPT number 1. Let us assume previously DEPT 1, here DEPT 1 field name. Here the DEPT number, in the sense it is a employee table DEPT. Here next. 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 Yeah, save it. That means you having the, that means you are going to employee, comes to the employee. What are the fields of employee? Employee number, employee name, and then salary. Department number 1 not added. You may add the department number. Click on edit. Here if you click on edit, here department number, add this department number and then save it. Yeah, you comes to here, go here. What is the thing here? With first you have to add field in a department. Here you have to add the different fields in a department. How can you add the fields in a department? Here what are the way? Click here. I am going to adding some fields for the department. Here what are the field? Department number. Here how can you represent the department number? Already I have a department. I am having the department number DEPT or otherwise department number is 10. The department name equal to CSC and then department location equal to HYD. Let us assume. Save and comes to the next one. Save and comes to the next one. Department number 20. The department number 20 is a, let us assume ECE, and then the department location is Hyderabad. Save and next one. And then comes to the department 30, the department 30 is a Tribuli and then location in Hyderabad. Save it, no problem. Enough. What is the thing here? If you comes to the employee, what are the values on a department? The department consists of department 10, 20, 30. Department number consists of 10, 20, 30. Department name consists of like this. Here, if it comes to the employee, I want to add fields in employee. How can I add the fields in employee here? For example, department employee number one, employee name. For example, Uma, employee salary equal to 8,000. See here. Here, this is a department number one. This indicates the lookup. Here, the department lookup here. That means you have to selecting the some of the fields from the employee here. That means you will selecting the any one of the field here. For example, I am selecting the department number. Save, next one. And then comes to the employee number two. Here, employee name equal to Rama. For example, employee salary equal to, for example, 9,000. For example, I want to add, for example, anyone here. For example, he belongs to the department number 20. Save on new. Here, for example, employee number three. Employee number three is a Bhima, let us assume. Here, Bhima belongs to 9,000, okay? Bhima belongs to bioinformatic department. Here, that bioinformatic department not existed on our table. For example, bioinformatic department, department number equal to 60. I want to add 60. Is it possible to add 60 here? Here, in this case, this is called here master detailed relation. Here, in this case, the record you are adding here is a, it's not, it gives an error here. That means invalid data, review of errors. In that means you will select the any one of the department, any one of the department here. It's not comes here. That means you have to remove this one and then comes here, selecting any one of the department, then only it will save. Otherwise it gives a error. This is called here master child relation or master detail relation or parent child relation. Here, when you are, for example, I'm adding, I want to add the another department, let us assume, for example, 40. Here, department number 40 or 60, let us assume 60 is a bioinformatic department. Department name equal to bioinformatics. And then either one, save it. Yeah, if it comes to here, how many values are there for the department? These are all bioinformatic department and then different values. Here, if you want to add the another record here is a Suresh. Suresh belongs to bioinformatic department. Here, for example, 04, here Suresh, here employee salary equal to 9,000, let us assume. And then he belongs to department number 60, bioinformatics. Here, the 60 is a bioinformatic. Other than these four values, you can't get the other than these four values. Only whatever may be value inserted in a department, those values may be inserted here. This is called here lookup relation. Save it. Here, this is a